What is the difference between blacks and Hispanics? There is no difference.
Teach!
Well, there is one difference. Our ships went in different directions. That's the only difference. Your ship went to Mexico, mine went to Virginia.
Right.
But guess what? Today, you got Latin kings beefing with Crips. Blacks and Hispanics are at beef, at odds. Why? Because we were taught to hate one another.
That's right.
Blacks and Hispanics were taught to hate one another. Going to Jeremiah to show you what Jeremiah told us about Judah. Listen, Jeremiah 14:2. Judah mourneth, and the gates thereof languish. They are black. What color did it say Judah is?
Black.
The Bible is giving you the color of the Jews.
That's right.
The Jews are black people. The Jews are black people.
Yes, right.
The Jews are black people. Now you may ask yourself, hold on. If those brothers are saying that the Jews are black, and we're teaching that blacks and Hispanics are the real Jews, what about the Jewish people in the land of Israel?
Right.
What about the Jewish people in Crown Heights? I'm gonna show you. Historically, Caucasian people, what happened? They're Jewish. Very good. They're Jewish. What does that mean? Why did he say that? They're Jewish. What does that mean?
Kind of like them.
Kind of like them. Right. You ever hear somebody say, you're acting childish? Are you literally a child? No, you're probably a grown man, 43 years old. But your wife, who don't like you, says you're acting childish. Are you literally a child? No. But you're acting like a child.
Teach.
Our Jewish people, yes, they converted to that. Listen to this, we're gonna show you. We're showing you today that blacks and Hispanics are the real Jews.
That's right.
Historically, we're showing you with a book, and we have other books. Now listen to this. My question was, but what about the other people who claim to be Jewish? They are Jewish. Look at this. Get me before we jump. Jeremiah 8:21. I want y'all to write these scriptures down. This is from the Bible.
Bring it out!
Latinos, oh, they all got Bibles. They all got Bibles.
Right.
Latinos fill the Catholic Church. They do. They have crucifix. Very religious. Our people are very religious. Listen good now. We're showing you color in the Bible.
Bring it out!
Jeremiah 8:21. Listen to this. Jeremiah chapter 8, verse 21. For the earth of the daughter of my people am I earth. Listen good. I am black. Wow! What book are we reading?
What?
Read it again. I am black. This is the King James Version. 1611. Where were Latinos 1611? Shackled up in chains. And we're reading out the Bible that our ancestors, Jeremiah, he says, I'm black.
Right.
Have you ever heard that scripture before? And do you go to church? I know you go to church. You Latino. I know you go to church. Our people are very religious. These are not scriptures they will ever read in church. Why? Because the pastor is not educated enough to show you this. Why? Because when he went to seminary school, they didn't teach him that in seminary school. They taught him, look, this is what they taught him. The pastors that went to seminary school taught him there is no color. Jesus Christ has no color. But people, brothers, think about this. My Latino brothers and sisters, how can you have no color? Well, did Jesus Christ walk this earth? Yes. So he had to have a color.
That's right.
Did they crucify him? Yes. So what color was he when he was on the cross? You know what people say? He was everything. Does that make sense?
Teach.
He was rainbow color. Jesus Christ has no color. Think about it. Does Barack Obama have a color? Does Donald Trump have a color? Yes. Does Mayor de Blasio Ozzy have a color? Yes.
That's
so
right.
What color was Jesus Christ? Black.
That's right.
And you know what some people say? Look, some people say Jesus Christ wasn't black. He was a man of color. That's what they say. You know what they're saying? They don't want to acknowledge he's black.
That's right.
Bring it out.
What's that, sister? The New York representative, the Dominican sister, you know, Ocasio-Cortez. Am I pronouncing her name right? Ocasio-Cortez, right? You know what I'm talking about, right? She was under fire. Why? Because she made a statement and said, Latino people descend from Africans. The media went crazy. They said, how dare she say that? How dare she say that? Remember, she's from the Bronx. She's from the Bronx. She said, Hispanic people come from African or are of African origin. A lot of people got mad. But guess what? She was right.
That's right.
And the Bible's showing you. Let me get Deuteronomy 28:48. I see we got a lot of Latinos listening. I want y'all to answer this question. Were Hispanic people ever enslaved?
Yes.
You saying, yeah, but you didn't know. I ain't saying it on your face. I know. You like, okay, yeah. Puerto Ricans, guess what? They were enslaved.
That's right.
Puerto Ricans were in slavery. Remember his name was Ponce de Leon.
Bring it up.
Guess what? Puerto Ricans, Dominicans, Mexicans, guess what? Spanish was not your first language.
Bring it
up. Y'all don't believe me. Listen good. Puerto Ricans, Dominicans, Colombians, who else we got in Yonkers? Mexicans, Spanish was not your first language. And they don't, Guatemalans, Cubans, Spanish was not your first language.
That's right.
Your first language was Hebrew.
Bring it up.
Your first language was Hebrew.
Bring it up.
Now read this Bible scripture. Come on.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 48. Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies.
Watch this.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
Hispanic people, listen good. Watch this.
In hunger.
The Hispanics, historically. Did Hispanics have to serve another race for food? Historically, yes, yes. They had to serve the Spaniards.
That's right. 1600s,
1545, 1431, 1612, 1711. Hispanics had to serve for food.
That's right.
In hunger and in thirst.
And in thirst. Historically, did Hispanics serve another race for water? Is this correct?
That's correct.
Are you just saying that? See, you're hiding under the mask. You're like, I can't see. Yes, yes.
Teach.
Historically, Hispanics had to serve for water. I wish I could speak Spanish, but listen good. Come on.
And in nakedness,
historically, did Hispanics have to serve for clothing? Yes. Everything we just read, what do we call that today? Slavery.
That's right.
Slavery. What is the difference between blacks and Hispanics? There is no difference.
Teach.
Well, there is one difference. Our ships went in different directions.
That's right.
That's the only difference. Your ship went to Mexico, mine went to Virginia.
Right.
Bring but guess what? Today, you got Latin kings beefing with Crips.
What?
Blacks and Hispanics are at beef, at odds. Why? Because we were taught to hate one another.
That's right.
Blacks and Hispanics were taught to hate one another. Listen good to what I'm saying. Blacks and Hispanics, you were taught to despise the American Negro.
That's right.
Hispanics, remember.
Bring it out.
The Negroes were brought here on ships first. Remember, 1950s, 1960s, Puerto Ricans start coming. And they are at odds with the American blacks. And then you had a group that had sense and said, you know what? We're black too. The group was called the Young Lords.
Right.
That's the Young
right.
Lords out of Chicago
That's
and New York.
Right.
The Young Lords turned into the Latin Kings.
That's right.
Listen good. Read this, Deuteronomy 28:48. Read it again.
Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies.
Come on.
Which the Lord shall send against
Come
thee
on.
In hunger
Come on.
and in
Now listen good. Remember, we all were enslaved.
That's and Hispanics. Right.
Listen good to this now. Come on. And ye shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck. Did Hispanics have shackles, chains on their necks? Were Hispanics shackled as well as Negroes? Yes.
That's
Do
right.
they teach this in high school? No.
Right.
No.
That's what?
No. They don't teach this. When I was in high school, I asked a Dominican brother, did you know that me and you were enslaved? He said, Dominicans were never in slavery. I said, what year did we graduate? Because I got to get the hell up out of here. Hispanics, you were in slavery as well.
That's right.
Why did you forget your history? Why? Because our Hispanic brothers and sisters are focused on lightening their skin.
What?
Are focused, the Hispanic women are focused on looking like the white woman.
What?
You must wake up and know your history.
That's right.
American Negroes and Hispanics were the same race.
Right.
Thus saith the Lord.
That's right.
Some people don't even realize Colombians are very dark skinned.
Right.
Come on, read on. The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far. Watch this. The Bible says God is going to bring a nation against the Israelites from far. Watch this. From the end of the earth, as swift as the eagle flyeth. What was the symbol of Spain when they came against the Hispanics? What was the symbol of Spain? Brother man, Boricua, what was the symbol of Spain when they came against the Hispanics? It was the bald eagle.
That's right.
It was the bald eagle. What was the symbol of Germany? The eagle. What was the symbol of Rome? The eagle. What's the symbol of America? The bald eagle.
Bring it on.
Now give me verse 68. Now here's the thing. According to these maps we have right here, I'm asking you a question. How did Hispanics get from Puerto Rico to Spain and Europe?
Boats.
Very good. How did Hispanics get to London? Boats. How did Hispanics get to America? Boats.
Teams.
Let's see if the Bible says thus.
Teams.
Verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Egypt represents the house of bondage. Why? Because the 12 tribes of Israel were in Egypt serving slavery.
Yes.
God says, you will serve slavery again. Read.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Bondage again.
With ship.
With what?
With ship.
What book are we reading? The Holy Bible. What people were brought to other countries by ships?
Bring it out.
Blacks and Latinos.
That's right.
God is not a man that he would lie. We're reading the Bible.
That's right.
We're reading the Bible. What are we showing?
The arrow.
Put this down.
The
oh, the arrow? Oh, yes, yes, look. Okay, so according to the map, you have Ecuador, ships coming over here. You have ships from Africa, Mozambique, coming over to Venezuela. Remember, the most amount of slaves were taken from Brazil. Sorry, oh gosh. The most amount of slaves were taken from Africa and were brought to Brazil.
Right.
All right? Look at this. A lot of our people, I don't want to say all, a lot of us came from the west coast of Africa, the east coast of Africa, and were brought where? To North, Central, South America.
Right.
This is the history we don't learn in school.
That's right.
Give me Jeremiah chapter 50, verse 33. So today, a lot of blacks and Hispanics, we at odds with one another. One day we were here teaching the Bible. I saw a short Hispanic brother. I saw another black brother. They pull out a knife, about to have a knife fight. He chased them down the block. A lot of Yonkers gangs are beefing with Hispanic gangs. For what? For what? Money, drugs, sex,
turf.
Colors. And we're the same people. Do Chinese people get down like that? No.
Bring it on.
Do white people get down like that? No. But blacks and Hispanics, we get down like that.
Hey.
Why? Because blacks and Hispanics, we're grimy. We're
shiesty.
Right.
We don't love each other. We don't respect each other.
Right.
We're wicked, the Bible says. That's why we have to repent. We gotta acknowledge our sins. The drug dealer can repent. The thief can repent.
Right.
The murderer can repent.
Right.
Right.
The point is repentance. The point is repentance. What's repentance? Change.
Right.
Acknowledge and change.
That's
now
right.
Watch this. Jeremiah 50, verse 33. Listen to this.
Jeremiah chapter 50, verse 33. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel and the children of Judah,
blacks and Latinos,
were oppressed together.
God says they were oppressed together.
Yes,
oh, we have proof. Look here on the map. You have Indians. Indians. Puerto Rico. Ponce de Leon. Mexico. Mexico. Hernan Cortez. Blacks and Hispanics, we have been conquered. That is our history. So what are we saying? Keep God's commandments.
Right.
Keep God's commandments.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.